Hello friends, welcome on this video tutorial. Daniel is here from Tips to Fix, and today I will show you a very interesting video. Today I will show you how to go back on iOS 15.5, the stable version. If you upgrade your iPhone to the latest version of iOS, I mean 16 beta developer version, I keep this version for a week to my phone just to test it and to see how fast it is and to see the new features. But the problem that I had with this phone, the battery is drying very fast and I don't like that thing. So they have to work on the battery issues. So I don't like the idea of notification to be down there here and at the bottom. So today on this guide, I will show you how to go back without losing any data. Okay, let's go directly to the point and let's do this video tutorial. Okay, the very first thing that you need to have is this lightning cable. I mean, is USB with lightning. But if you have your MacBook Pro here or your MacBook Air, you have to have your USB-C to lightning cable to connect your iPhone, I mean my iPhone here, with the computer, okay? In my case, I will use this cable. It's very important. I have to have also here in my Mac, I have to have iTunes. But let's try to connect. Yes, and then you will see a notification here to allow and trust your iPhone to connect it on your computer. But here, if you see, I have here Daniel's iPhone, my iPhone here. But if I click here to synchronize settings, then you will see here on the Finder, you will see here, and let's go here on your iPhone, and you will see here all your iPhone settings. Okay, in my case, I didn't do any backup yet, but what I suggest you to do first is that you have to reset your iPhone settings, because it's very important that there are some settings that are set on iOS 16 that are not compatible in a version 15.5, okay? So let's reset the settings. Let's do it right now. Okay, let's go here on the settings, general, all the way down, transfer or reset this phone, okay? And then let's click here, reset all settings. Put your password. Okay, here with this reset the settings, no data will be deleted, okay? And then click here, reset all settings. And iPhone started to do this reset settings, okay? After we are done with this reset settings, we will do a backup directly on the computer, okay? So now what's the next step? The next step is turn off Find My iPhone. It's very important to Find My iPhone will be off. And now it needs my Apple ID. Okay, Find My iPhone is off now. Even if we do anything wrong here or something like that, you need to have your phone on iCloud backup, okay? Go here on the computer now. And then on my iPhone here, what I gotta do, I will just hit this backup all the data on this Mac, okay? So this is an offline backup in this computer, and I have to have the backup here on the computer, okay guys? We need to have the backup because with this backup we will restore in the moment when we go back on the version 15.5, okay? So this backup will take a little. I have a lot of files, so it will be 100 gigabytes for me. So what we need to do now, you have to go on this website, IPSW downloads is the operating system that we need to have for our iPhone. We'll go here on iPhone, close this, and then in my case I have here iPhone 12 Pro Max. So if you are on iPhone 13 Pro Max, you just come here and download it and go ahead to download the iOS version that you need. I need this one, 15.5. It's the stable one and the one that I really like. Let's download this file. It will be 6.5 gigabytes. In my case, this one will take 3 minutes. I'm backing up my iPhone and I think this process will take a little, okay? So I will come back to you guys when this backup is done and then I will show you what you have to do next. We have to restore our iPhone now with this iOS that we downloaded, okay? To choose the manual file, what you gotta do, you just, if you are on a Mac, you have to keep and hold the option button. If you are on Windows, you have to click Shift and then click the Restore iPhone, and then you will see this Windows will pop up, and here you will choose the manual file that we downloaded before. Click Open, and now you are able to restore your phone with this method. As you see, is your Mac will erase everything and restore the phone on version 15.5. So click the button restore and your Mac is preparing to restore the software on this iPhone, okay? If this method doesn't work for you for any reason, maybe your Apple doesn't allow you to choose the manual file, then there is another method that I really like, doing this process with a clean install from recovery mode. Let's do it with recovery mode right now. So what we have to do is just click this volume up once, volume down once, and keep and hold the power button. Keep and hold the power button till you see the Apple logo, and after that you will see recovery mode. Make sure this cable is connected, okay? So keep and hold it now. You see the logo? Keep and hold it now. Okay, here it is. Release the button and now we are on the recovery mode. Okay, so we connect this with computer. Look at this now. There's a problem with iPhone that requires to be updated or restored, okay? So what I gotta do now, we'll click cancel here because I have to click here, restore iPhone. And what I have to do, I will erase everything here. Restore and update. Your Mac is preparing to restore the software. Let's wait a little. Preparing iPhone for restore. So let's wait. We will wait a little. The process is started, as you see. Okay, look at this. It's downloaded directly from Apple. And then now you will see that iPhone is restored without needing to manually download or something like that. You will choose the way. If it works for you, choose the method one. If it doesn't work, choose the method two. Okay, iPhone restarted and your iPhone has been restored. Okay, click OK here on this window and let's see, my iPhone will open up now. Hello. Okay, here it is. Now let's try to set it up. Good. Set up manually. We'll click continue. It will take a few minutes to activate your phone. Okay, set up mobile data. Mobile data, continue, continue, set up later. And now use anyway. Good. I create the password. Okay, set it up, set up your phone. Okay, don't transfer apps and data. And here it is. Sure, we have to log in with Apple ID. Okay, we need to allow here from the screen. You want done. And now, terms and conditions agree. It make few minutes, more few minutes. Okay, good. Continue. Welcome to iPhone. Here I am. Let's go to about and look at this 15.5. Fine. Now we need data back. So what we gotta do now to restore all the data that we needed here, we need it back. Do not restore from this backup, okay? Click here, setup as a new device. Click continue. Okay, now I have this as a new device. And click here, manage backups. Okay, look, I have here a backup that I did today. What do we have to do on this backup? Right click here on this backup, show in Finder. Then what we gotta do, just go all the way down. We have here info.plist. Open this with text editor. Other, let's see any text editor here if I have. We can use text editor. Yeah, text edit, open. Here you will see on a text edit, search Control F and search product version. Okay, here it is. You will see here product version is 16. We need to make this 15, okay? Make sure to save this and then close and close again and click OK here. If you see this button now green here and you are not able to click this button, if you see this unavailable, then it means that your iPhone name is changed and then it's not the same as it was before. I mean, now is iPhone, but before it was Daniel's iPhone and now is iPhone. So what we have to do, we have to change the name again of your iPhone. Let me show you real quick. General. Here, click here about. Good. What I did, I just disconnected and connected again. You will see here Daniel's iPhone, and then I have the privilege to restore the backup. I will click here, restore the backup. And I will restore this iPhone today. And I will click restore. Find my must be turned off before Daniel's iPhone can be restored. So I will go back and turn off Find My iPhone as I showed you before. Okay, Find My iPhone is off. And now let's click the restore button. A restore is on progress and you will see it here. Restore on progress. We will wait maybe 30 minutes or something like that. And now as you see, the phone is ready to use now. Swipe up to upgrade. Try to swipe up. Okay, put the code. Samsung, okay, here it is. Swap up and then you will see this message, restore complete, and it's connecting to my Apple Watch. Okay, so now you have to try to set up your phone again and everything will be back as it was before. Thank you guys for watching this video tutorial. This is how you can go back from iOS 16 beta version to iOS 15.5 stable version without losing your data, photos and everything, okay? Don't forget to subscribe, Tips to Fix, and share this video with your friends. God bless you, see you on the next video tutorial.